Well, a list is out of the new cabinet secretaries that William Ruto, the president, has selected. This is a confidential list sent to me by some of you, and you have asked me to go through it and explain. We have people who have retained their seats as cabinet secretaries, and we have others who are new. So, number one on the list, we have Rebecca Miano. She will be cabinet secretary for energy and petroleum. She hails from Nyandarua County. She has served as the managing director and CEO of KenGen, Kenya Electricity Generating Company. And she has an extensive experience in the energy sector, particularly in power generation and renewable energy initiatives. She will be in charge of overseeing energy sector, including electricity generation and petroleum and other in renewable energy projects. I believe this appointment will be okay because she has an experience in that docket, and because we are Kenya needs someone who people who are experienced in each docket. We don't just need to pick people of political affiliation like the president did earlier. Number two, we have Professor Kithure Kindiki. I think Kindiki is a smart person, but the president appointed him in a wrong docket, which was the docket he was managing. But we hope this one, it is the best for him, because Kithure Kindiki is going to be appointed as the Attorney General. He hails from Tharaka Nithi, and he is a seasoned lawyer and a former senator for Tharaka Nithi County. He has served as the Senate Majority Leader and has a background in constitutional law. So he has been a cabinet secretary, now is coming back as an attorney general. His role will be the chief legal advisor to the government. His responsibility, he will be responsible for legal affairs and upholding the rule of law. I hope he is a smart person and he will be the best for this docket. He will be ensuring the legality of government actions and will be providing legal guidance on policy implementation. Since he is a lawyer, I believe that docket will be good for him. Number three on the list, on this leaked confidential list, we have Monica Juma. She hails from Murang'a County. She will be secretary to the cabinet. She has worked in the Uhuru regime and now Uhuru Ruto regime, and now she is with Ruto working with the Kenya Kwanza government. She has retained since up to now. She has served as a Kenya's cabinet secretary for defense and foreign affairs. She has distinguished career in public service and diplomacy. Her role will be to facilitate the operations of the cabinet, ensuring efficient communication and implementation of cabinet decisions. Okay, she will be in her position will be for coordinating government policies and decisions. So for this appointment also, it is good. I wish the president would have chosen this kind of people before, earlier on, not now. Number four on the list is Aden Duale, who hails from Garissa County, and he will be cabinet secretary for defense in the Republic of Kenya. Aden Duale is a veteran politician and a former majority leader of the National Assembly. He has significant experience in legislative processes and governance. He has been also in the dismissed cabinet. He was the Minister for Defense, or if you like it, a cabinet secretary for defense. And he has retained it. His role will be to manage the national defense and military operations. His docket is important for maintaining national security and defense. Okay? He only slipped a little bit when he assigned military to go to our streets. And yet the police have been deployed in Haiti. So I believe he will rectify on that. But the docket is still okay for him. I believe he is fit for that. That's my view. Professor Olive Mugenda. She will be in charge of education and she hails from Kiambu. This is a good appointment because the president, when he became the president, he appointed Machogu, who was a former DO. He doesn't have any experience about education. You understand? And this person, he is supposed now to transition from 844 to CBC. You see, now, this one was a very bad choice because I don't even the MPs who vetted these people, that the president, they had a right to say, no, education, we cannot mess our education by choosing this person. We need to get someone else who can work for the nation. So Olive Mugenda will be okay for me. I believe it is the best choice. So Professor Olive Mugenda is a former vice chancellor of Kenyatta University. She has a strong background in academia and education management. This is the people we are talking about. This is the people who should manage our ministries, who should steer the country ahead. Her role will be to oversee education sector, including policies and programs from primary to higher education. This ministry is crucial for shaping the education system and ensuring access to quality education, okay, in the Republic of Kenya. Number six is a new person, also who is none other than Dennis Itumbi. Dennis Itumbi will be Cabinet Secretary for Information, Technology and Digital Economy. He hails from Kirinyaga County. Dennis Itumbi is a digital strategist and a former State House Digital Director. He has expertise in digital communication and information technology. His role in this ministry will be to manage IT infrastructure, digital economy policies, and technological advancements in the Republic of Kenya. This ministry that Dennis Itumbi is going to head is vital for promoting digital transformation and innovation. Number seven will be Alfred Mutua. Dr. Alfred Mutua will be moved to the docket of water and sanitation. Previously, he was holding as cabinet secretary for tourism. So, Alfred Mutua is a former governor of Machakos County. He has a background of governance and public administration. Okay. His role will be to ensure access to clean water and proper sanitation services to the whole Republic of Kenya. This ministry is essential for public health and sustainable development. So it's crucial. He has been retained and we hope he will wake up and work for the people. We don't have to have people who are just there to complain. We need people who will work. Number eight is a new entrant, and this is called none other than Joshua Oigara, who will be in charge of public service transformation. He hails from Kisii County. Joshua Oigara is the former CEO of the Kenya Commercial Bank, KCB. He has experience in corporate management and financial services. His role will be reforms and enhances efficiency of the public service. He will focus on improving service delivery and governance. Number nine on the list is Charles Hinga. He will be in charge of lands, housing, and urban development. He hails from Nakuru. Charles Hinga has become a principal secretary for the State Department of Housing and Urban Development. He has expertise in urban planning, housing policy, and housing policy. He will be in charge of managing land policies, housing programs, and urban planning across the Republic of Kenya. His docket is important for addressing housing needs and urban development challenges. Number 10 is Ababu Namwamba. Ababu Namwamba will be Cabinet Secretary for Youth Affairs, Sports and Arts. He hails from Busia County. Namwamba is a former Member of Parliament and has served as the Chief Administrative Secretary for the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. He has experience in governance and youth development. He has been retained in this ministry because also we have AFCON that is coming to East Africa, and they began building stadiums. I hope he will deliver, apart from few things that they say he brings along a lot of ladies. I do not know. What people are crying, bringing more ladies in your circle, like when you're traveling, what should not be a problem, but he is doing so using public funds. That's what people believe, and that's why people, they don't like this guy. So I believe he will transform the sports sector and the youth affairs. Number 11 is Adan Mohamed. Adan Mohamed will be Cabinet Secretary for Trade, Investment and Industry. He hails from Mandera County. He is a former Cabinet Secretary for Industrialization and Enterprise Development. He has background in banking and finance. He will be in charge of managing trade policies, investment promotion and industrial development across the whole country. His ministry will be crucial for economic growth and attracting investments and investors from all over the world. Number 12 is Salim Mvurya. Think Mvurya has been brought in so that he can balance the tribal or the regional equilibrium. You know this country, but I see the Gen Zs are trying to sway away from that kind of thing. Salim Mvurya will be Cabinet Secretary for Labor and Social Protection. He hails from Kwale. He is the former governor of Kwale County and has experience in governance and social policy. His role will be to oversee labor policies, social welfare programs, and worker protection. This docket of Salim Mvurya will be to ensure fair labor practices and society social security. Number 13 is Kipruto Arap Kirwa. He will be in charge of the agriculture and irrigation. He hails from Trans Nzoia County. Kipruto Kirwa is a former cabinet minister for agriculture. He has an extensive experience and agricultural policy and rural development. He has extensive experience in agricultural policy and rural development. Okay, so he will be managing agricultural policies and irrigation projects. His docket will be vital for food security and agricultural productivity across the whole country. Number 14 is Nicholas Gumbo. He will be Cabinet Secretary for Economy and Maritime Affairs, and he hails from Siaya County. Nicholas Gumbo is a former Member of Parliament and an engineer by profession. He has experience in infrastructure development. His role will be to oversee marine resources, fisheries, and maritime activities. The docket is important for exploiting marine resources and deploying the blue economy and developing the blue economy. Number 15 is Musalia Mudavadi. Musalia Mudavadi will remain the Cabinet Secretary for Foreign and Diaspora Affairs. He hails from Vihiga County. He hails from Vihiga County and he is a veteran politician and a former vice president of Kenya. He has extensive experience in governance and public administration. His role will be to coordinate government activities and manage foreign relations. This docket will be key for diplomatic relations and government coordination. Number six is Dr. Mercy Mwangangi. She will be Cabinet Secretary for Health and Medical Services. She hails from Taita Taveta County. Mercy Mwangangi has served as Chief Administrative Secretary in the Ministry of Health. She has a medical background and experience in public health. Her roles will be to manage healthcare policies, medical services, and public health initiatives. This docket is crucial for ensuring public health and medical services. Number 17 is Soipan Tuya. Soipan Tuya will be Cabinet Secretary for Climate Change, Tourism and Wildlife. She hails from Narok. I think Narok is where Masai Mara National Park is. Soipan Tuya is a former Member of Parliament and has experience in environmental policy and wildlife conservation. Her role will be to manage policies on climate change, tourism, and wildlife conservation. This docket is essential for environmental conservation and tourism development. Number 18 is Suzanne Mudhaura. She will be Cabinet Secretary for Cooperatives and MSMEs Development. She hails from Meru and she has experience in cooperative management and small businesses development. Her role will be to promote cooperative movements and developments of macro, small, and medium enterprises. This docket supports small businesses and cooperative societies. Number 19 is Engineer Frederick K. Kirui, Cabinet Secretary for Roads, Transport and Public Works. He hails from Kericho County. Frederick K. Kirui is an engineer with extensive experience in infrastructure, development and public works. His role will be to manage infrastructure projects, roads, public and all public works. This docket is critical for infrastructure development and connectivity. This docket now is in the right hands because the president had put there Kipchumba Murkomen, who is very dysfunctional. He could not do anything because he doesn't have any background in construction or anything. He is not an engineer, he's just nothing. So this is a good move. I support this appointment. Number 20 is Weekly for Paranya, who will be in charge of National Treasury and Planning. He hails from Kakamega County. Oparanya is a former governor of Kakamega County and he has served as a minister for state planning. He has a background of finance and economic planning. His role will be to oversee financial policies, budgeting, and economic planning. This docket is important for financial management and economic stability of the Republic of Kenya. And so I believe this appointment is okay. Some people are complaining that Oparanya is on the ODM, I don't know what. We need a functional country. We do not need to talk about parties. If an individual can work for the development of this country, we have seen that this guy, for the 10 years he was governor for Kakamega, a lot was done. You go and in Western Kenya, the only county that is developing that is okay, it is Kakamega County only. Others are still backwards. If you check Bungoma, Trans Nzoia, this Vihiga, Busia, these counties have been, for 10 years of devolution, they have, we've seen nothing completely. But for Kakamega, there is progress. They have a stadium, they have a level, a new level 5-6 hospital, they have a lot of stuff is going on there. The roads, there is street lights everywhere. This county is developing. Under it, it developed under Oparanya. So I support this weekly for Oparanya's appointment. If he will be appointed, I believe Kenya is heading the right direction, because these are the kind of people that are ready to work for the people. They are not ready to amass more wealth. They are ready to work for the people. Number 21 is Grace Mercy Osewe. She will be Cabinet Secretary for African, East African Community and Regional Development. She hails from Homa Bay County. She has experience in regional development and East African community affairs. Her roles will be to manage regional development initiatives and East African community affairs. This docket will promote regional integration and development, because you know we need to have our East African Federation. We need to unite very soon. And so this docket is very vital towards that achievement of having East Africa as one state, one cooperative state. Number 22 is Joseph K. Boynett. He will be Cabinet Secretary for Interior and National Administration. He hails from Elgeyo Marakwet. Boynett is a former Inspector General of the National Police Service and has extensive experience in security and administration. His role will be to manage internal security and national administration. This ministry was under the person who will be appointed as Attorney General, Kithure Kindiki. And he did not perform, he tried well, but he did not perform well because that is not his skills. He is not skilled in that. Okay. So Boynett's docket will be to ensure internal security and effective administration across the whole country. Number 23, Nancy Kibaba will be Cabinet Secretary for Culture and Affirmative Action from Bungoma County. She hailed from Bungoma County, I mean. Her experience, she has experience in gender advocacy, cultural development, and her role will be to promote gender equality, cultural development, and affirmative action policies. This docket will be to support gender equality and cultural preservation. The finance bill sparked nationwide protests led by Generation Z, who are demanding President Ruto and his government to resign. The main points of context were increased taxes, and they need a workable government that is working and everything. So I think Ruto, the president, should look into these things and implement them. He should not get back on top of his car. He should now get to work. He should get people. If he should start acting now, but it is as if that he doesn't see. He want to play cat and game, like he want to play smart. No, you have to just sit down, Mr. President, and work for the people. I think that one is the better way you can save yourself from this mess. People are saying we are tired of promises. We are tired of everything. We just need to see a working economy. We want to see everything moving swiftly. We want to see the health sector okay. We want to see the education sector okay. We want to see our roads being done. We want to see everything in place. We don't want more talk. We don't want people who do not care. And another thing I can advise the president that is that he should make sure that those public committees, parliament committees, people like Imani Ichungwa should not be near them. People like Kimani, the other Molo MP, I don't know the other name, Kimani, I don't know who, they should be removed from those dockets. We need new people who think, who can advise the president, who can think and tell the president, this one is not logic. Let us not go this way. It will bring anarchy. It will bring this. These people are just I think if you read some books, we had Kifo Kisimani or something like that. There are some people who are called Vibaraka. So these people, they are misleading the president. They are burying this president alive. You see, they must tell him, no, we cannot do this. If he refuses, they should resign from those dockets so that we should not blame them. People like Kichungwa and Kimani, Kuria, they should completely be removed from those dockets. And if you are watching this video for the first time, kindly consider subscribing to this channel and hitting the notification bell and like this video. So see you in the next video. I hope you've understood the new cabinet that has been leaked. And I believe you can let me know in the comments below which people do you believe they should be there, they should be retained, or I don't know. Just comment, let us know. And we will keep on bringing more. Just subscribe to this channel, guys. Make sure you subscribe. We just need at least you subscribe to this channel to support us. The only way you can support us is to subscribe. Just click the subscribe button, and that is it. We love you guys, and let us meet in the next video. And Kenya is one, and we shall prosper. We have a working economy. We have people who are ready to work. And so let us move forward. Let us advise the president accordingly. We want to move together as one, and that is all I can say for now. That is my view. I don't know what is your take. See you.